Hey guys, I am doing another video today. This time with this Blue-Red Flash deck with Kaldheim, featuring a lot of the new cards. There was a deck I posted on Channel Fireball on the website, the strategy part of the side from LSV. I thought the deck looked really cool. We're currently playing the release Streamer Showdown. I still don't know the name. I still have no clue. The streamer event, their early access streamer event. So thanks to WotC for inviting me, for giving me the account fully stocked with every card and everything. And yeah, I just want to try this deck. I think it looks really cool. There's a lot of cool stuff going on. There's a little snow theme going on with the Snowlands. Obviously now we have the snow covered lands in the set, plus the snow tapped dual lands, so it's pretty easy to get enough snow lands to activate Faceless Haven, which I think is a really, really strong land because sort of kind of reminds me of Mutavault. Obviously a little more expensive to activate, but 4/3 Vigilance is a pretty big attacker. Plus you have access to Frostbite, which is sort of a lightning bolt. It doesn't really go face, but it goes to planeswalkers and creatures, and dealing 3 damage for 1 mana is quite reasonable. The other really strong new card, and possibly one of the actual best cards in the new set, is Goldspin Dragon. And this card is amazing. It's a sort of like Glorybringer, 5 mana 4/4, flying haste, deals 4 right away. Flying, that's pretty decent already. But whenever it attacks you or becomes a target of its spell, you get to make a treasure token. And your treasures, when you have the dragon in play, they make 2 mana instead of 1. So you get to immediately use that 2 mana to maybe protect your dragon with something like Negate, or maybe just Daneful Stroke to counter their Doomscar. You can use the mana to bound something with Brazen Borrower and do all kinds of stuff. The way this deck plays out is if you remember the Blue-Red Flash deck from about 1 or 2 years ago, I think it was played at the Mythic Invitational. A lot of the Pantheon players played it. I think Huey, Reed, most of them were on it. It was a really, really, really good deck. It's a very fun deck. You get to do a lot of most of the stuff you're doing. You get to do at instant speed, thanks to cards like Bone Crusher Giant and Brazen Borrower and Shark Typhoon. You never really have to tap out on your own turn. So the dragon is like the only card that you really play on your turn that you really have to tap out for. But the fact that it sort of makes you 2 mana when you attack means that even if you have to tap out for you on turn 5, you still get to keep up some mana for counters thanks to the treasure that you make. The rest of the deck is a bunch of card draw and just interaction with your opponent. And this is another new thing from Kaldheim. It's called Foretell. It's an ability that lets you pay 2 mana and set aside a card with Foretell into this Foretell zone or something. Just basically set it aside. It's like morph. It's sort of like a morph mechanic, but for spells. So I can just pay 2 mana anytime I want to do it, to set this aside. And then for 1 in blue, I can play this at instant speed because it's an instant, and draw 2 cards. 2 mana, draw 2 cards, scry 2. It's a pretty solid deal. And there's also a counter spell that lets you do the same. So it remains to be seen if the Foretell ability is really strong, or you get to maybe just bluff something you don't have, or the other way around. But yeah, I want to try it out. With the counter spell, for example, you sort of pay more if you do it that way. You pay 2 to sort of morph it, and then 2 to unmorph it. So you end up paying 4 mana, but sometimes you just don't have anything to do on turn 2. So it's gonna make it cheaper in the future. So let's see how it plays out. I'm mostly just excited about the dragon because that card looks really cool and really, really powerful. And I like these kind of decks. I like the flash kind of decks. I like stuff where you don't really have to tap out on your own turn. You're playing everything at instant speed. You keep your opponent guessing, and the deck just looks really good. So let's give it a try. Blue red flash. Keep in mind we're playing the streamer event, so the only option to do right now is best of one. There's no sideboards. Everybody's trying out brews and everything. So this is mostly just to get a feeling of the new cards. is Gold Spend Dragon really the next best thing in standard? Is it just okay? Basically, we just wanna find out how good the cards are. So everybody's just trying stuff out, and everybody's just mostly trying to have fun. So, don't expect the format to be solved in the first 6 hours or something. This is mostly just to see how good the cards are. Pretty good hand here. If they play a creature, I get to bunker something. Although Yorion, this is gonna be like Abzan, Esper, something around. Extremely unlikely they have a creature. Maybe if they're Abzan, they're gonna have the Tangled Florahedron. Yeah, I'm just gonna go phase here. Because against these kind of decks, you just need to put some pressure in play. And Bookrush Giant does exactly that. In the future, I'm gonna be able to start holding Disdainful Stroke. Yeah, I think this is as good a draw as I can possibly have. Turn to an interaction, then play a 4-power creature that also doesn't really get stopped by the wall. On turn four, I can. I'm gonna call it suspend for a really long time before I get used to it. I get to foretell Behold the Multiverse for two on my turn, and then if they don't play anything, I'll use it to draw two. If they do, I can still use Disdainful Stroke. So that is pretty nice. Skyclave Shade. That's not a usual card you play in these kinds of decks. That's interesting. I really want to draw two, so I just want to shock myself. Rather than play the tapped land, I like this a lot better. I would have loved to bounce it, but I would just rather draw the cards right now. So, Foretell, Bass. Now, this could mean a lot of things. This could be Saw It Coming, so it could be the counter spell if they don't play anything. If they're like, okay, well, he has a counter, so maybe I'll just play one of my bet cards to try to run into it or something. We're gonna be like, oh, we have a draw too. Instead, next turn I can attack with the dragon, make the treasure, and immediately use that to do something. Sure. They already played a land. Respond by drawing. I want to have the. Ooh, I think I just take both, right? Yeah. Discard the tap land. Wow, this is pretty good so far. Obviously, it's day one, people are trying stuff out, everything's gonna look good. But this is a pretty good curve. Okay, so I get to play this as a red source, play the dragon, attack, pass, make a treasure. And if they don't block, I can actually just win next turn. I get to bounce something with Brazen Borrower to just make sure that the Bonecrusher Giant connects. And I can also just counter the Doom Foretold. Yeah, pretty good game so far. Pretty good game one. Now if they leave the prince behind, I can just play the dragon, attack, make the treasure before blockers, bounce a prince. Wow, you love to see it. Thanks for playing. Not too bad, not too bad. It was a pretty good game one. Pretty good showing by the dragon so far. I love this card already. All right, let's play some more. Thank you. I like that Luis has already kind of, I think he already played with the deck. I was just talking to him before making the video, and I think the list already looks pretty reasonable. Like, obviously day one you're gonna have a lot of, you know, new cards in the deck just to try them out, a lot of two offs, a lot of one offs, but this version has already been tried out a little bit on Luis's stream. I think he played some games with it. It just looks pretty good. It just looks like, you know, there's a great curve. There's a good mix of like hard counters, interaction with the opponent, just some removal spells, just some bounce spells. Are we gonna find a game here, by the way? What's going on? I thought there was like literally thousands of people waiting to find a game. Yeah, I really wonder what the new format's gonna look like. I kind of hope something is going to really shake up the format, but on the other hand, like, it's going to be really hard for something to be better than Embercleave, the Great Henge, Into the Story, and, you know, those kind of cards. Yeah, I'll keep that. I would love to have another untapped land for turn 3, but can't have it all. I think you should probably play 4 of the tapped duels, the snow ones. Let's get ourselves an island. So given that they played this line on turn 1, I think it's going to be something like Red-Black Sacrifice, where I'm pretty likely to use my Bone Crusher on turn 2, and I would love to play it on turn 3 afterwards, so I'm just going to go for that play. Oh my god, Village Rites? No. Okay, Frostbite. Oh, alright, that's fine. That's fine, we can live with that. Now I don't really want a Foretell, because I would rather scatter something important here, I think. Although I could have Foretold, and then next turn draw two on my own turn if I don't draw a land, and then hit a land drop, and then use my Scatter or Negate on the turn after. So something would have resolved. But this is also fine. I can Cycle Shock Typhoon, but I think it just Foretell here and pass. Just hopefully draw a land next turn. That's a big creature. Protection from extra from Planeswalkers. All right. Okay, so I guess I just pass. It doesn't really matter what I do with this. Pass, I bounce this. Probably bounce this end of turn, actually. Oi, 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 that's not good. I guess I draw first, huh? Although I can also just trade Borrower. I can trade Borrower for the Valkyrie. Yeah, I think that's probably the best, honestly. Is it the best? How many outs do I have to the dragon? Yeah, I'll just trade. Because if I draw, if I draw the lightning bolt, I can't kill this anyway. If I draw the Foretell counterspell, I can't use it anyway. Oh, you hate to see it. This dragon is so good. No. Yeah, I need something better than that. We're kind of screwed here. I think I'm just literally dead. If I drew a land at least on my turn, I could have cycle checked Typhoon to make a 3/3, traded with this, and then very likely drawn into a fourth land and just traded with the dragon. But we just drew a bunch of expensive cards and now we can't really do anything. Maybe I should have kept the land so that I can at least Shark Typhoon into a 1/1. I think that would have been better. I think I probably just messed up a little bit. And next, yeah, now I'm just kind of dead. Yeah, I have to shark for 0 now. Yeah, now I'm just too far behind. I'm gonna go to 4. I guess I could draw a brazen. Okay, never mind. All right, we dead. Yeah, it looks like the format's probably gonna get a lot more aggressive. It's nice to be able to play all these Yorion decks and food and dirtle around with, you know, Witch's Oven and Trail of Crumbs and drawing cards and playing auras and blinking your stuff, but this dragon is no joke. This is probably going to be the new meta. Yeah, so far Kaldheim looks pretty good. Yeah, this is exactly the kind of hand I'm looking for. Exactly the kind of opening hand. Some number of interaction, but also creatures, so you can put in some pressure. I think I want the fourth dual land. I think I want the extra snow dual land. Just because you really don't have anything to do on turn one anyways. I guess Luis does have 3 of those Shadow Skull smashing, so there's that. Sure. I think I want to go aggro. I'll just bounce it. Yeah. I really miss Glorybringer. Every time I draw this card, I'm like, yeah, it would have been so nice to just play this. Exert, kill your guy. Just play Borrow right now. Fine. Mill 3. Return up to 2 targets, no permanent cards from your graveyard to your hand. Choose 3 cards in each graveyard. Shuffle them back. Okay. I think I want to save Negate for something better. They got a Jorn Snow. Reasonable. Sure. I get the Cyclo Shark Typhoon. Next turn I'll put a +1/+1 counter on up to 1 target creature. So the Dryad's gonna get bigger. Exile target creature with the greatest power. That's a little bit annoying because it kills my dragon, but I mean, it's gonna take a while before we even get to the third chapter. I mean, I just win a lot faster. If I just Psycho Shark Typhoon, play the dragon, that's 9 damage. They put another counter on something, and I just win next turn. That's fine. I guess it kind of depends on what they have, but I think I win this race pretty easily. Sure. Make a 2/2. OK. Okay, so I have to three myself, but that's not too bad. It's not the end of the world. I think everything attacks. Now we have the treasure, so I can play any of these three cards. And next year I have another Goldspin Dragon. You love to see it. They can play two big cards though, like having the snow thing. Means they kind of just get six more mana right now. So I'll only be able to counter one of those. Actually, does it even matter? Six. I would go to one. Maybe it's better to hold up Negate? I'm honestly not sure. I'll counter it. It might be wrong, because I just have no clue what they have. But that could give me another turn. Like, they need to deal with my stuff. First and foremost. Sure. Does it have reach or something? All right. Let's just get a bunch of lands, sure. So we can play the dragon, attack, bone crusher. So I can attack for 15 right now. You do love to see it. Yeah, this deck is gas. This deck is gas. Oh man, I can't wait to brew with this set. There's so many like good midrange creatures, which is exactly the kind of magic I like. Like, we had so many like Fires of Invention decks and Reclamation decks and all this stuff lately. And just everything was revolving around Planeswalkers. And it just feels like if that you play a Planeswalker, it snowballs and you win, you don't really have to do anything. Like, creatures that just good old honest work. Just have to actually attack, play around sweepers and stuff. I'll keep it. I two lands is not exactly perfect. Like, you would love to have the third one. But I think it's a pretty reasonable hand. Like, any hand with the Bone Crusher and Brazen Borrower is a good hand in my books. Alright, there we go. I don't think I want to foretell anything. Do I? Kind of just want a Bone Crush or something. Like, if they play a creature, I really want to be able to kill the creature. Like, if I knew my opponent's deck, that'd be a lot easier to make the decision. Well, if I knew they were playing blue, then it would be an easy foretell of one of these cards. So, I guess we're going aggro now. If this is a blue eye control. They get priority? What'd they get priority for? Is there something that costs one blue? Oh, opt, yeah. Miscast? What? No way. No way that just happened. Oh my god, are you kidding me? No way. Oh. No. Oh, dude. My 4-3 just got countered for one mana. Oh, you hate to see it. You hate to see it. I think I'm going to play Borrower. Even though I need to make the fourth land drop to start playing all these spells, I think just putting on the pressure on the control opponent is just more important than that. Wow, imagine losing Bone Crush Giant to a miscast. You hate to see it. That's fine, I guess. Yeah, I just want a Psycho Shark Typhoon. I don't really mind. If I knew they were looking for lands, then I would probably counter, but Last Cascade. Dig three. That's fine. I guess I just draw that. Oh, wait, that's a... Oh, okay, okay. I was like, why can't I play my four mana card? Are you gonna miscast me again? Please don't do it. Oh, they get parody again. No, no. Okay. Kind of like the land. Yeah, I'll keep the land. Again, pressure is really important. Oh my god, another Shark Typhoon. You love to see it. You do love to see it. Yeah, that's not happening. Oh, that's not happening. I want to cycle this for one. So let's just pass. I wanted to make a token and then attack with the Faceless Haven for seven and still keep up two mana. Sure. You gain 2 life for each card you foretold at 2. Second target card, sure. Okay, now the question is, do I attack or do I just Shark Typhoon again? Probably Shark Typhoon. It's really hard to evaluate like these new sagas that, especially the ones that work with Foretell. This is gonna take some time to figure it out. Doomscar, that's okay, I guess. This land is so good. Oh my god. They're just gonna die to this land. Tail's End in standard? I think it is. Destroy all creatures. Guess they get to return Doomscar back to their hand. Yeah, maybe this card's playable. I think I make this into a creature and attack. Because I'm gonna get 4 mana still, yeah. Keep double blue, yeah. Let's see what they have. Attack for 8. The fact that this has vigilance is so busted. Like, you spend 3 mana to deal 4 damage. That's insane if you're an aggro deck. And pretty decent even if you're a control deck. I think I Bone Crusher that actually, because that lets me lethal them next turn. And they will probably Doomscar. And they just lose to the Scatter. To the Negate, I mean. Yeah, they just return Doomscar, we Negate, and bam. Game's over. Thanks for playing. They returned the draw to? Okay. Never mind. I mean, our plan was pretty simple. Yeah, this deck is gas. I want to have another Faceless Land. That card is just super good. You don't want to really draw two in this kind of deck because you need double blue and double red, but you really want to draw one every game. That was a pretty good showing by Faceless Haven. Now, what can I cut though? An island? I guess I can cut an island. Let's go. Wait, what? Oh, we need to grab the land, sure. Blue red flash. Another perfect hand. Like, basically, with this deck, if you have a Brazen Borrower or Bonecrusher Giant in your hand, like, that's already. And two lands, that's basically already a keep. Because you have a turn 2 play and a turn 3 play, which is pretty amazing. Tap another. Tap and untap creature you control. And this is like Loam Dryad, right? Oh, nice. Elves. Okay. Okay, okay. 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 Kill this guy, I think. Although I don't need to do it right now. I'll do it right now. I don't want them to play some kind of like pump spell or something. I don't know if that's a thing right now in standard, but maybe it's more likely they play a Lord. But even then, I think I just need to get rid of this guy. They can play Elves from the top of their deck. Pretty good. That's also pretty good. I think I just need to bounce it probably. Oh yeah, I'm gonna wait for them to shuffle the. They didn't shuffle? What? Come on! Greg the Fabled Passage. Let's go. Let's go! Oh wait, this is not. Why am I thinking of Aether Gust? Why am I thinking of Aether Gust right now? Llanowar Visionary, huh? Well, I guess I just Bonecrusher that then. I need to find Frostbite. Something to deal with a 2-3. I can't just keep bouncing it. If I had a counterspell, that would be a lot more appealing to bounce it and then just counter it on the way back. Also, why'd they use this to get the mana? I guess they wanted to crack the Fabled Passages, sure. Yeah, well, I guess we're killing this one then. I guess I just need to find a fifth land. I take seven. Next turn I play the dragon, attack, bounce something, take a million. Oh man. That looks pretty impressive in their deck. I am so dead. I am so dead. Yeah. No, and no. I need to find like double Frostbite. That's like the only way. Yeah, we had a lot of bone crushers, but we couldn't really deal with a three toughness creature. So I can play the dragon, attack, bounce lord, take 3 for 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I die anyway, so yeah, I don't have anything to deal with this. Nice, that was pretty good. That was a nice showing by their elf deck. It was really fast too. The 2/3 looked pretty strong. Just gave them like what, 3 or 4 free cards from the top. Not too bad. Not too bad at all. Yeah, this is where you would bring in those Storm's Wrath and similar cards out of the sideboard. Maybe something like a Fire Prophecy or Dragon, Scorching Dragon Fire. No red mana, but I think it's still an okay hand. Like, we have a lot of stuff to do. We're in the draw, like, we get an extra card. I think that's reasonable. Human Token 1017. Hello, opponent. Would you like to play a match of Magic? Hello? Wow, I was expecting creatures, but this is not really a sign of a creature deck. Mono red control. I guess it could be the same thing we're playing. It could be blue red control, something like NJ Cuneo played in the MPL League some time ago. Alright. If you don't speed this up, I'm probably gonna fall asleep here. Alright, we cycle the Shark Typhoon. No reason to use Borrower to... no reason to use Borrower to bounce this. It's not even good at this point. I just need to hit my third land drop, so... Seems like the play. Our opponent really is not the fastest. Alright, that's a red source. And now the question is... I think I just play Borrower here. Bonecrusher, I mean. No, that seems bad. I want to play the Borrower, I think. And hold up counter magic. And like, actually maybe just counter the Borrower. Tectonic Giant. Just thinking of which counter spell to use. As much as I would like to use the expensive cards so that I can keep as many cheaper cards as possible, I think it's better to use the Stroke now. Because they might just end up playing a lot of more cheap cards in the next couple of turns, and I'll just be sitting here with this in hand. That would just feel incredibly stupid. Shock Foretell or play the step? Play the step, I think. Yeah, we're gonna come to that. If I had another snow permanent, that'd be an easy frostbite, but I don't want to risk not drawing a snow permanent and just randomly taking 8 damage before I bounce it or whatever, and then just take even more and then even more. This deck is a lot fun to play. Wait, did they scry instead of drawing? What is happening here? Torbran, huh? I can bounce that. That's not a big deal. That's fine. I just really want to cycle the Shark Typhoon here to make more land drops. My opponent's probably the slowest player in the whole thing. Oh my God. Dragon. Whenever this is dealt damage, it deals damage to target opponent. It fights another target creature. So with Torbran, I can just bounce it, right? Sure. Really want to be able to use two cards in this turn. So like I'm hoping they attack with Torbran, and then I block and finish it off with the Bone Crusher, and then I block the other guy. Or then I bounce the other guy. There we go. Can I play this? I think so. I'm not gonna be able to hold up a counter spell, but that's okay. Wait, no, no, not this one. This one. Yeah, I have another Borrow Relic. What's the worst that can happen? Tectonic Giant, sure, got it. Faceless Haven. This card is so good. It just makes so much mana. How does this work? Whenever it attacks, I can just bounce it and that's it. Although, I can also maybe just let it attack. No, that's not happening. I can just do everything. I can play Bone Crusher. Pass. Bounce this with the Borrower. Still keep up 5 mana. Oh, that's pretty good. Do I even want to counter that? Not really. Sure. Okay, it also does that when it becomes a target, huh? I should have just traded these two creatures. That would have been better. That would have actually been better. It's not really gonna matter, but sure. So if I attack with the Faceless Haven, I take 4 from this. I'm at 11. Three, make this. I'm at 11. They're at 8. And then I need 6 mana for this and this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm gonna have 8 mana, so I'm more than good. But I have to tap all blue, but that doesn't matter. That doesn't matter. I'll just crack this now. We pass. Fight another target creatures, they can fight between each other. I think we counter this. 2 blue, I guess 1 color less. Okay. Should have seen it coming. Wait, I should just hold up the counter, right? There's nothing that can happen. If I do it this way. The Borrower doesn't, like the 3 damage doesn't even change the clock anyways. It's actually the worst I can do is play the Borrower, and then they use something to remove the dragon and something else, and all of a sudden I only have 7 damage. I can't counter. They almost killed me. Like, they would have been able to block and fight something, but obviously the after they block, it goes in the stack, and I can also kill my creature in before it actually happens. But they almost actually killed me. If I was lower in life, I would have countered the 1/1, but that was actually looked somewhat close. Alright, I think that will be it. I want to try more other decks. More new decks, more new cards. But yeah, this was pretty good. The deck played out incredibly smoothly. Luis obviously put a lot of thought into it. I don't think anything really underperformed. Like, everything was okay. I think this overperformed. I think the land is really cool. I think you do have enough sources. Like, Fabled Passage is basically another snow source. So you have, what, 14, you have 17 snowlands, or even including these, so 19 or 18, because you're going to have one of them. So you have 18 other snow sources, which should be plenty. Like, it's not a land you need to activate on turn 4. You're usually looking to activate it on turn like 5 or 6. And especially with all the extra card draw you have in the deck, I think you should be pretty easily able to find enough sources. Yeah, it played out really nicely. Like, the counters are good. The adventure creatures were insane. Shark Typhoon was really good. The dragon is amazing. Yeah, sideboard's obviously going to be... That obviously depends on what people are going to end up playing. Like, if it's going to be a format full of aggro control or whatever. It's impossible to really make a sideboard right now. Or not impossible, but, you know, hey, here are some cards. Some of them are good against control. Some of them are good against aggro. But who knows what the format is actually going to be. For every target creature, Planeswalker, add for each one. I didn't lose. I think Storm's Wrath is probably one of the most... Storm's Wrath and Negate are one of the most impactful cards you can have at the sideboard. If there's a lot of control in the format, you maybe just want to play four Faceless Haven. Because that card is just, it's such a pain in the ass for the control decks. They're going to be looking at Glass Caskets and Doom Scars and you know, all this kind of removal. And this is just going to be like, yeah, I'll just hit you for four and I'll hold up a counter and your turn. And yeah, Goldspun Dragon also kind of looked really strong. So yeah, that's it. Blue-red Flash. Give it a try. Pretty good deck. Definitely one of the best cards in the new set. And this is might be one of the sleepers because I haven't actually seen this in a lot of lists, but I think the line is insane. I think the line is really, really, really strong. And it's going to be like Mutable Wealth. It's just going to be in a lot of decks because especially, well, the monocolor ones. You're not going to really be able to play this in three-color Ebbs and Urion because the mana is not going to work because you're not going to have all snow color, snow basic lands, but pretty good land, pretty good deck, pretty good feeling about it. Give it a try, and yeah, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time.